Peter wanted to buy a bag, but he only had 1/5 of the money. After receiving $12 from his father, he was still short of half of the money. What is the price of the bag? So here we have, okay, the cost of a bag, right? Okay, and right now Peter only has 1/5 of it. So Peter says that after receiving $12 from his father, he's still short of half of the money. So if I were to withdraw this, this means that, okay, if I add $12, okay, to what Peter currently have, this will be half the price, okay, half the amount of what Peter is required. So let's find out how can we find the full price, okay, of the bag. So in this case, what we want to do is to actually, okay, make sure that the fractions, right, have the same denominator. And why you want to do that is because it allows us to compare easily. Okay, right now 1/5 and half, you know, it is very hard to for us to compare side by side. But what happens if we change 1/5, okay, into 2/10, and we change 1/5 half into 5/10? Now what you realize that is that after receiving $12, can you see the fraction increased from 2/10 to 5/10? And what does it mean? This represents that 3 units is $12. 1 unit would then be $4, and therefore the price of the bag, okay, price of the bag would be $40. Okay, so very importantly to know that all you need to do is to make sure that the denominator is always the same for easy comparison, and this will help you to achieve your answer more quickly. Okay, $40.